Nnamdi Kanu is not in any way maltreated in custody. Accusations of maltreatment negate the services standard operation procedure on the implementation of rights of a suspect. Two, Nnamdi Kanu enjoys full luxury in the holding facility, incomparable to any of his type anywhere in the country. He is accorded full rights and privileges. He is never denied his right of worship or freedom from his select religious practice. Adequate attention, that's number three, adequate attention is paid to Kanu's health. He has unhindered access to the best medical care and doctors. Kanu himself has confirmed to his visitors that the service has never in any way maltreated him. He even confirmed this to the quartet of Senators Ike Ekweremadu and Eninia Abaribe, Bishop Sunday Onuoha of Methodist Church Nigeria, and co-chair Interfaith Dialogue Forum for Peace, and Ambassador Okechukwu Emuche, MFR, Secretary General Ohaneze Ndigbo, who saw him on Wednesday, 8 December 2021. That's to say that the four persons as mentioned saw Nnamdi Kanu on Wednesday, 8 December 2021. And he affirmed to them that he is not maltreated by the service. Four, the story of Kanu being stabbed is fallacious. He could not have been stabbed as he enjoys meals of his choice. That he is not allowed change of clothing is also false. He is regularly allowed change of clothing as against what is presented to the public by IPOB propagandists. Assuming he is being maltreated, how come his visitors told him he was looking well? All the allegations of violation of his rights as a suspect, victimization, and starvation, among others, are not true. They are not true. It is unfortunate that some elements have decided to use outright misinformation to represent the state of affairs. Those who make these stories do so to attract undue attention for the singular purpose of achieving a desired end. Rather than focus on how he should get justice, Kanu's legal team and some mischievous elements among them have chosen to use fake news to mislead the public. While the court, in its wisdom, ordered that Kanu be remanded in the safer DSS custody, some of his legal representatives, for reasons best known to them, preferred Kuje prison and have failed to explain the rationale for such choice. It may interest the public to note that a particular lawyer among Kanu's team is feasting on the matter, such that one could conclude that his interest is beyond getting justice for his client. Be that as it may, the court has the final say on the matter.